Hallelujah. Now I want you to know the gathering we are into. By God's grace, by God's power, what I want to tell you is that my name is Abraham Krumah. Some people call me Apostle Krumah. I appreciate your life. But Apostle Krumah, I can't hear you. I can't help you at all. But I want you to know that the helper is in our midst. I can't restrict the move of God. No. For God to move, it don't take me. No. Without me, he been moving. In my absence, he's still moving. I came into the world and I met this world. God will forever be moving. If you say amen, people will understand what I'm saying. He been moving and he will move again. You say amen, God will move at your direction. Now, whatever you are, what I want to say is that I want to say a few things to us as we move in that prayer time. Amen. You can pray from your radio. You can pray from your house. You can pray from anywhere. This is a praying gathering. The reason why we are experiencing what we are experiencing is because when we pray, something happens. I don't want us to prioritize, oh, miracle, the main professor. No, no. I called the church on the radio. I said, I don't want to hear that nonsense. I don't want to hear it. What happened has happened. Only God alone be the glory. So if we pray, anywhere people can pray. The Bible says, where two or three are gathered in my name. When you pray, so we expect ourselves to go back like that after having a kind of massive prayer. You expect to go like that? No. Amen. Yes, when we pray, something happens. So maybe what is about to happen tonight could be for you. You say amen, will be for you. I'm not able, I don't have the power to make anything happen for anyone. But if we pray, my responsibility is to tell you the secret, or to tell you the principle. What secret? The principle. Amen. That if we pray, something happens. I want to say it so everyone can have it at the back of their mind. That if we pray, now if we take the we and put I, if I pray, something must happen. Amen. Yeah, if you pray, something must happen. If you pray, once you pray, the Bible says in Luke chapter 18, you read verse 1, it says, men always ought to pray. Men ought to pray and not to faint. Men always ought to pray. In the mighty gospel, Luke, John, Jesus said, pray always. And I told the church in one prayer section, I said, the reason why we are ought to pray always, because wickedness is at all times. Why you should pray always is because of what the enemy is doing at all times. We live in a world where our enemies are restless. The day you rest, somebody will rest in your family and you rest in peace. Are you hearing what I'm saying? We live in a restless generation, a generation of restlessness. You learn how to wrestle. You learn how to fight. You learn how to pray. We have to take issues very serious. We have to come to the place in our lives to understand that in this world that we are living, it is your constant communication in relationship as a whole. No matter how beautiful the woman may be, how beautiful the woman look like, or the handsome of the man, beauty and handsome don't keep a relationship. What keeps a relationship is not love. You see? I stalk you now, you're looking at me and say, ah, it's not love, then what now? What keeps a relationship is communication. You see? You're not let true. Check it. Check it good and see. What keeps relationship is communication. I don't care how you love a person. Lack of communication can kill love. Oh? Are you getting my flow? Are you getting my flow? Now, let me tell you why. Let me tell you why Satan entered the garden. Are you with me? Yes. Now, God gave Adam a big wife, very beautiful, right on him, loving and caring. The reason why God took this lady from his son is that he should be able to maintain the communication, stick her. The day I get my wife, I will stick up with my son because no demon. That amen, I'm correct.
If you say amen, you are envying me.
Hey.
So God tell Adam, say stick her, by where? Your son. Stick up by yourself. In the sunny day, because we're living in a world of wickedness, you see a 12-year-old boy approaching a woman that is legally married. La brain, not true. You don't like reality. Are you here? We're living in a world where the children are demonized. You will see a man cry. Say, I like you. See a ring on your finger. So if you marry, press your wife. Give her one to one. She take one step. It's true. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Are you hearing what I'm saying? Let me tell you what lack of communication can do. You people could be married and you all love one another. If communication is absent, the love will die. You get what I'm saying? If communication is absent, the love will die. I don't care how you love that person. There are many of you here, you have taken love to airport. Lovey, lovey. You kiss to the terminal. You kiss, if you enter the plane, they give you chance. You are kissing, 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 kissing on the person on the plane. They go. And they turn your back. You come back. You call. The day you start lusting, talking. No. Let me tell you something. The substance of love is talking. It's communication. Another translation, another people say, definition say, sacrifice. Okay, sacrifice is good. But I prefer you sacrificing your time for talking than your money. Talking. Because we live in a world of young babies. All women want to be babies. And there are papa who want to be a kid. Wait. You will see an old man, gray headed. When we have to call him baby. You see? And for each time, he start to lose that word baby. He start feeling bad. Why are you eating the food in the house? Because he's not calling me baby again. Are you here? I'm not deviating. I'm right in the circle of prayer. Prayer is communication. Are you here? Eve and Adam were together in the garden. God said to Adam, I've given you the garden and I've given the animal thereof. So any name you call them is what it's going to become. So Adam has forgot his wife and he now become a pursuer of animals. He has left his home. He started lecturing with the tiger, with lion, and his wife is alone. Loneliness. No matter who a woman is, don't give us space for loneliness. It's not good for no woman. She can marry to you there for 10 years. Do that thing. Go read your Bible. Loneliness is a blessing for a woman. If you marry, I'm not even married, see me now. Oh, that way, small. If you marry, ain't good for destiny. If you give a destiny, say your gate man will replace you. You see, you Liberian, not that true. Are you here?
Yes.
Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Yes.
Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Yes.
If you hear me, say I hear.
Yes.
Say it again, say I'm in charge.
Yes.
So God asked him to take care of this woman and the woman should help him. That was the role of the woman in the garden, in the life of Adam, help him in everything he's going to do. So he was to make sure to keep this home is to continue to talk. I felt like it is about putting good food in the house, putting some apple in the freezer, putting some mayonnaise and peanut butter, you know, in the cover, putting some bread. Then I have a more grill it. Eh? I put everything in the house. Stay, what do you want? You don't even know. Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Yes.
Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Yes.
Have you seen somebody get everything in the house to go tell a friend Zimmer and dress? Let me lay down. Everything there. Why? There are people, no matter what you put there, listen, I can tell you, you can put everything in the house and you take communication for someone, you have killed them. Then the thing you have given to them in the house. How do we eat the thing in the house? When you're not talking to the person. Are you here?
Yes, sir.
All of a sudden, he left. Lacking of communication. The snake came. Shh. In the garden. Hello? We mean it's the outcome of talking. When they talk for meaning, they can get malaria.
Yes, sir.
A woman talk for an hour. She go to work. Nobody to talk to. She will go to the internet, check in here. If everybody shut down, she will ask Facebook why. Why are you not online? Looking. And as I'm telling you, why looking for someone to talk to? Loneliness. Satan kill me. Loneliness give platform for Satan. Satan comes to manipulation. Are you here?
Yes.
What are you doing here? Nothing. What's your husband? That careless man. That don't care papa. He always with an animal there. Satan says, so what you been eating? Women let talking. We eat apples here, we eat this one. And so all these things for you? Oh yes. For us. But since I get to know myself, I always talk to my husband. But then where you coming from? I never knew that we have other people, other families. How will you say you have other families? But you don't blame the lady. You blame the man. And even when going in the kitchen, tie her chair or her blouse. Yeah. Me, I get a wife, I get you 6 feet, me. What are you talking? I beg you, yeah. If I get a wife, I will not get you 2 feet. I'll buy my tail root.
Sir.
Measure your destiny. Your destiny will be measured. If you are to your friend, I'll be to your friend doing my car parking. Well, friend, can't bring a friend. Say, yeah. Yeah. Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
The snake. The Bible calls him the serpent. The serpent said to her, oh, look at apple, this one. So the snake came and said, but you can eat that one too? You know, learning that when you don't talk for long, you have to eat pancata boy. You know what pancata boy is? You can eat your more. You won't talk. Oh, she has found talking partner. Let me tell you something here. Can I tell you something here? You can't take one day to win a person. You can win somebody one day. So if you read the Bible, it will tell you that it wasn't just that day. Many people don't understand, they don't calculate. It wasn't just that day that Satan deceived Eve. They've been talking. Anytime you go, he will come in. How you doing? Hi, everything. So what's your husband? Oh, he out. There is no way in the world. Nowhere to deceive someone at that high level. It's not possible. They've been talking. She got so congested. She got used to the conversation. And then he now comes in. But then you thought, now how did he manage to know that God said you shouldn't eat? They've been talking. If they've been talking, Satan would have said, okay, so what God said, you should not eat here. Woman said, God said we shouldn't eat this thing here. We shouldn't eat this one here. Anyone will give us knowledge. They won't give us knowledge. They went into deep conversation. No, who tell you? Forget that thing. Eat. check it, lack of communication. She eat it. When she ate it, she took peace. She went running. She said, I'm tasting anything sweet. The man said, what? I said, the sin tree will be evolving. I tell say, she didn't tell the man, say, the snake on the fire. You get you my flow?
Yeah.
A fire before she confessed. That was not me, like a snake. But when the snake should come, she tell the man, snake will come in there. Are you what I'm saying? The snake now caused big trouble. Say it. When Adam saw it, Adam too, so stupid. He has no question. They say, oh, the tree, I say, we shouldn't eat. I eat you, but taste it too. You collect it and taste it. It's not my point. My point here is, what brought problems in the world? Lack of communication. So the God that you can talk to can defend you. You get what I'm saying? Can defend you. So in life, what made God? Now, when people say, oh, you know, and anytime you pray, something happens. Like how? Ladies and gentlemen, it is not possible to have a friend that is so best to you, so used to you, and then you fall into trouble and you die that friend no more. And that friend avoid you or in know you. Once that friend is addicted to you, you're talk constantly, you're regular in your talking. Anything that person doing, as soon as you say, hey, this one happened to me, the person will drop everything and it will run to you. That's why he said, call on me in times of trouble. But you can't call on him when you don't have a relationship with him. We are yet to build a relationship between we and God, that at all times when we call on him, he will answer our call immediately. I want to talk to some people here. By the power of the Spirit of God, I speak to your life. The appetite for God, the communication between you and God, you say amen and settle to them. Shout out, yeah! Sit down or sat down. Anyone, just sit down. Are you here this evening? I hear people say, oh, I came to you. Why? I came to you so you could go talk between me and my husband. We're not talking. Me, I suggest that you will first settle the issue with God. Because the Bible says, if your way pleases God, he maketh your enemy to be at peace with you. So the first place you should settle from, settle the difference between you and God. If you were not close to him last year, you have to draw near to him. James said, draw near to God and he will draw near to you. If you were distant away from him, you have to come a little bit closer and tell him, God, cast me not away from your presence. Take not the Holy Spirit away from me. Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation. If your amen is the loudest, everyone that went far from God, you are coming closer. Amen. You are coming closer. Amen. Shout out, yeah. The first issue in your life that you must settle. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
People sit down, dig on bone. They are settling between the pastor and the members, the family and the wife and the nephew. Ladies and gentlemen, in this life, your greatest settlement is between you and God. If you can settle the matter with God, every other man in your life, they are noise. If you can settle your difference with God, you who used to be so close, you who used to pray at all time, you who used to fast and fast like ever before, you who always were constant when it comes to prayer, but because of that person that came closer to you, I make you not to pray anymore. You who used to fast and fast like a fasting giant, you can't fast anymore. You who used to take a special day, sit by yourself, lock your door, and stay all day inside only because of God, but because of that friend, that relationship, you have turned your back on God. Before the
pray some may come to an end, we yet to settle our difference. Father, we come to you as people, as citizens of this country. Have mercy, O Lord. A calling to that loving kindness, a calling to that tender mercy. I was sharpened in iniquities and in sin that my mother conceived me. Watch me, O Lord, and I will be clean. Watch me, O Lord, I will be wetter than the snow. Cast me not away from your presence. Don't take your Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me the joy of that salvation. I am yet to prophesy. You are about to receive restoration. Divine restoration. Divine restoration. Divine restoration. Shut fire!
Fire!
Hey. Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
Hey.
Church, if God be for you, okay. But if God become your enemies, ladies and gentlemen, the Bible says he bare them by his spirit from the wilderness to the promised land, and the thorn to be his enemies. When God is your enemies, you end. When God is your enemy, everything about you end. Ladies and gentlemen, when you see people that used to love you turning their back on you, friends that used to be there for you turning their back on you, you who they were paying an increase of salary, things are all going down on you, everything is collapsing on you, run back to God. I'm not talking here. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. What the righteous runneth in, they are saved. What the righteous runneth in, they are saved. What the righteous runneth in, they are saved. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. You shall say to the wicked, he is my salvation, my strength, and my redeemer. You don't serve a dead God, you serve a mighty God. He's the same yesterday, he's the same today, he's the same forever. When God lifts you up, no man can bring you down. When God promotes you, no man can demote you. God is on your side. Power is on your side. Favor is on your side. I did not hear. I did not know. There is an everlasting God. There is no such thing to his understanding. He gave a power to the faint. He gave a strength to the weak. The young men may fall, the youth may fall. They that wait upon the Lord, he shall renew their strength. Lift up your hand and shout hallelujah. I said shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. Sit down, say aye. The apostle, he said that I may know him and the power of his resurrection. Daniel, the revelatory, Daniel said, he that knoweth his God shall be strong, shall do exploit. He that knoweth his God shall be strong. The God you know will determine how far you will go. It is the God you know in these last days will determine your stand in this wicked world. I'm not talking to somebody here. If you know God, I'm not a boss, Catalabahaya. People will know you. If you know God, people won't turn your back on you. If you know God, the earth will bow down to you. If you know God, all
those that went away from you, they will turn back to you. If you know God, your enemy will bow to you. If you know God, you can live a low life. If you know God, you can die like dog. If you know God, you are resurrected. Say, Father, that I may know you.
Are you here this evening?
Hey.
Are you ready to pray?
Yeah.
Are you ready to pray?
Yeah.
Now, I will say this to you, and I move on. Are you here?
Yeah.
Now, the reason why in this life many people pray and they don't get the answer. When you pray and pray and fast and you don't have an answer, one, you lack relationship. People ask us, say, teach me how to pray. If you want to pray, your first step, build a relationship. The crelly you buy, spending time buying data, crelly, you lay, finding 3 days to talk to people, find time for God. In your life, find time for God. At least as a woman, find time for God. As a pastor, find time for God. You get time to your neighbors. You get time for your husband. You get time for your kid. But you don't have time for God. There are times in your life, no matter what happened to Daniel, the people said Daniel should not pray because he had become a governor. So he's not to pray. They stop him from praying. Daniel turned to the whole authority. You can have your job. You can take everything you have given to me, but you can stop me from praying. They said Daniel should not pray. Daniel said it's a lie. They wrote the decree. They said no man should call upon their God for the past 30 days. Daniel said this one is a lie. Why Daniel said so? Well, at him I am nothing. If I don't talk to him, I don't sleep at night. If I don't talk to him, I don't have peace at night. If I don't talk to him, I don't have rest at night. If I don't talk to him, I don't sleep at night. You say amen, you are the one I am talking. Shout I am.
I am.
Shout I am. Said I say I'm a child.
I'm a child.
You're a governor now. You are a governor now. But right now, forget about the praying stuff here. Yeah? You were praying so God could give you a job. Now you have the job. So all you do here after work, put your air conditioner on, lay down and relax. Daniel said, you are a fool. The man that gave me the job, how can I forget him? We live in a generation where people, when they are promoted, they forget about who promoted them. The gift is not important. The giver is better than the gave. I'm not talking to somebody yet. If he gave it to you before, he can give it to you again. I don't like the way you are shouting that your head man out. You say amen wherever you are. What God gave to you before, what is about to give to you now, is going to be bigger than what he gave to you before. Say your amen well. Shout it well. Shout it well. Sit down, say, aye. Write it down. Keep it at the back of your mind. The giver is better than the gift. The power of the gift is the giver. Are you here?
Yes.
The life you're bluffing with now, who gave it to you? Oh, okay. Only then see, there are people who don't recognize that they are former beggar, they are former slave, they are former wrong room owner, they are former single person. Now you have a ring on your finger, you don't become a woman for yourself, a man for yourself. When it comes to God, no big man, no big woman. He's the superior. He's the King of kings. He
is the wonderful counselor. He is the prince of peace. I call him Yeshua the Messiah, the Lamb of the tribe of Judah, the ancients of days, the yesterday, today, and forever. I'm not talking here. I'm not preaching to someone here. Daniel call him the ancients of days. Jehovah Makadishka, Jehovah Shalom, Jehovah El Elohim, Jehovah Akshadah, Jehovah Nasi, Jehovah Charah, Jehovah Sekenor. If your amen is still loud there, something is happening here for you. I don't like that your amen at all. Shania! Many people ask a question saying, why? I pray, I don't get the answer. Number one, it's because you lack relationship. Church is not a swamp. What does that mean? Church is not a holy house where you just get the problem and you just run. I can't with my tafo in my body, who pull it there? Eh? Like God pull it there? Eh? I can't so he can heal me. You see the kind of generation we're in? We don't know how to approach God. There are many people say, I pray, I don't get the answer. You don't pray without a relationship. The first thing is relationship. Relationship is not just about money and about things. Relationship is about concern. Concern. When you eat it, is my God stay alive? When you are at your office, Father, are you still on the true? Who am I preaching to here? Relationship is concern. And why the Bible says, in times of trouble, whether good or bad, give him thanks. If you are in the middle of a situation, what things are tangled around you? God, are you still there? If you are preaching or crying, God, are you still there? If you are on a breakfast table, God, are you still there? The first thing about God is that he lacks concern. And I can tell you, there are many of you here, you lack concern more than any other thing. Concern. Why I pray? Let me tell you something here. In these last days, what people can, anyone that give to God, anyone that help God, anyone that bless the things of God, are people who concern about God. If you are concerned about God, you don't need a preaching message to give. If you are concerned about God, you don't need a pastor to tell you, say, oh, anybody that gave $5, why are we making God small for 5 ugly nickel? He's bigger than your damn, your nickel. Even if he's bigger than 20,000 Liberian dollars. I'm not talking here. He's the creator of the universe. He created the universe. He lived outside the universe. He's God all by himself. Without you plus you minus you, he's the God. Tell your neighbor, say, he's the God.
He's the God.
Shall say, he's the God.
He's the God.
Concern. If you concern about God, no man of God will tell you, say, can't give. We have careless fathers, careless mothers, careless parents, careless family. I mean, you're looking at me now. If someone don't call your phone, you won't die. See the thing you want all the relationship for? I walk out of the relationship because you're not concerned. You left concern more than sense. Concern. If in this world you concern about anything, make God your first concern in your life.
Yes, sir.
I'm not talking about prayer. I'm talking about prayer that have answer. If you must pray and get an answer, find relationship. What is relationship? There are many of you here, you force yourself on people who not even want your conversation. You know how to pull yourself around there to get to them.
But when it comes to God, and to this Sunday, and you know my clothes not pressed, and I saw my clothes here, and you're not too tired. But when you won't force yourself on people, when you won't force yourself, there are some of you that are in relationship, they are kicking you, flogging you, stepping you, but you say you can't go. You bow down like Goliath. You say, if I go, you must kill me, kill my mom, kill my pa. You are acting like have to say that where you are, they are forcing you there. But when it comes to God, you get plenty of excuses.
Yeah, you saw.
You know how to force yourself. Let chiclet stick on chair. People will not want to hear you. Your men wait to get around them. People will not want to talk to you. You found a miss. I wish I was talking. I wish I was saying something.
Yes, sir.
I wish I was talking to somebody here. I wish somebody get in my head. If you get in my head, say, ah, yeah. I don't hear that floor. I say, say, ah, yeah.
Yeah.
Concept. Many of us look like there is no God in our life. Nobody can see you and know that you have a God. Because in your own life, there is nothing likable. What is in your house symbolizing God? Your children father picture, all of them go. All of them picture on your room. Your former wedding, the male already gone. The wedding picture stay in the room. Am I talking here? Am I talking here?
Yes, sir.
Your our same friends, all their picture in your room, your living room. But tell me your symbol, your Bible, a way to the dirty part of the cross. Eh? Where part of your life that people can enter and they see God through you? Where? Why people will say that? That's why what I do, I'm too happy. The happiest man on earth, so be at the age preaching gospel, I'm the happiest man. I'm happy and I'm the happiest man ever in my life. Yeah, I don't need money. I don't need anything. The fact that I am being among those that are privileged to preach the gospel at this age is a blessing. I can jump. I can shout. I can bounce. I can turn around. I can spring.
Yes. Oh.
You must come to the church. Your stomach beat a frog. Your foot beat you on you. You not almost go. If the fat dying, then you say, hey, a pastor. The way a pastor come out, can be jump out. Jump like that. You will finish soon money. Jump. Don't see me jumping. I get strength behind my jumping. I get strength behind my jumping. I'm the most privileged man of God ever. That have seen myself at this age working for God. As I say, they're making me jumpy. Hey, you don't serve a dead God. Go jump. Jump. I saw you do that. Yeah, yeah. You say, oh, the man can talk. Yeah. Somebody says, man of God, you say, you talk like, can you preach when there is no power? There are more good teachers, but they are out of power. And if you preach and you don't have the grace of God upon your life, your preaching becomes an irritation to people. It's when you preach, people tire. There are places where me, you come in the church, yeah, and then you sit down with that kind of BB speaker, and then with that kind of voice, standing looking inside the day, and then screaming. Then you sleep, yeah, you will sleep, yeah, you come in that kind of voice, you sleep, where you are pastor, sleep. I was shouting, yeah, yeah.
John the Baptist came from the wilderness. He baptized the people. But when he baptized the people received Jesus and Jesus blessed them. Mosquito, malaria can't go by that.
There's a John the Baptist. The kingdom of God suffered with violence. Violence taken by force. Are you yet?
Yeah.
Are you yet?
Yeah.
Jesus said in the Bible. He said, oh, yeah, man. He said, you can't wash for an hour. What does that mean? You can't pray for an hour. You can't pray for 1 hour. You can't even pray for 15 minutes. You expect to see something? Where? They make it as confusion. Oh, all the people running, all the people running. You owe. Even though that's not all, refuse to be all. Oh, you owe. Power of God, Spirit of God, relationship, consent. If you have a consent and you build consent between you and God, you're so concerned about the first priority in your mind. Can I tell you something? All the days of my life, from 2008 up to now, I can tell you the biggest thing in my mind. I don't need to tell you, but if you sense me in your spiritual woman or man, you will know. My major concern in life is God. It's true. My greater priority in life is God. People who know me, people knew me from the small building. People knew me from the mat. People knew me from D15 radio. People are surprised. So when they say Abraham Kumar, they just feel like Abraham Kumar from Guinea. You were running behind a cow on the can reach from Mali all the way to Guinea. Nana Tepo grew over here, pushing continuously, putting pressure, concern. My major concern in life is God. So when you hear people talking, yes, ma'am, how God can do what he want to do? Or how we can see what we are seeing? Because my day to day, man, I can tell anybody to the glory of God, when it comes, I'm a pastor, a man of God, where I don't respect the thing they call money. I don't have what regard for money. Money is not part of my agenda. I don't know it, and I don't want to know his mother name or his father name. I don't want to know the family from. I don't have any respect for it. Because it's one of the things that kill anointing slowly. I get money, I'm a blessing with money, the first place I run in, God. If I give anything to you in the name of God, anything I do in the name of God, anything I try to exercise, let it be for God. What we do, because we have God in our mind. We have God in our mind every day. So if I tell you, say, in the name of Jesus, you are healed, it's not a name that I am a stranger to. It's a name that I am a friend to. I have associate with the name. Am I talking here? Am I talking here?
Yes, sir.
Yes. An associate. I read the word of God. I read the word. Reading the word. I pray. Prayer. Which kind of prayer? God, grow my ministry. Ministry is not mine. So I don't pray that prayer. God, grow my ministry. No. God, give me grace. No. God, give me faith. No. God, use me. No. God, help me to be great in the world. No. What is my prayer? Father, I want to know you. Every day of my life, I want to know God. Father, I really want to know you and who actually you are. Because it is your level of knowing God, like knowing faces, that makes you a physician. I'm not talking here.
Yes,
it is your level of accounting you do that makes you an accountant. I'm not talking to somebody here. Every day of my life, I want to know you. I see punishment, and at times, the way we know God is different from the way we Liberians expect to know him. Sometimes we want to know him by being a blessing to us. No. Knowing God is not just about being a blessing to you. Knowing God is going through calamity and stay standing for God. Going through shame and stay holding your repetition from God. How do you know that you know God? In the midst of your trouble, no shaking, no change of mind, no removal from where you are. In the days of your situation, your challenges and your breakdown, no matter what happened to you, you keep your repetition. I like what the wife of Job said to Job. Are you going to maintain your integrity? The man said to her, I can't curse God. How do you know God? Because God will carry you through the test of time. There are some situations in our life. They are for test of time to bring you a testimony. So in the midst of that testing, you hold yourself and keep your faith and keep believing in him and keep trusting him. You may not have the miracle last year or the miracle this year, but you are still hoping.
hoping, because faith is the substance of things hoped for. You are still looking up to him. For they that put their trust in him shall not be put to shame. You may not graduate yet, but you are still hoping. You may not get married yet. Ash is not in your favor, but you are still hoping. You may not get a child now, and ash is not in your favor, but you are still hoping. You might be in another world going through a challenge where everyone have abandoned you, and you look up to people and they turn their back on you, but you are still hoping. Friends may promise you, they may not fulfill their promise, but you are still hoping on God. I'm not talking to somebody yet. If you say amen, you will not give up easily. Shout out, yeah.
I am.
What? Our prayer.
Don't get the answer. It's a lack of concern. Concern. Daniel, you're supposed to pray now because you are a governor. You're supposed to pray now. You should be at the law-making place. Oh God, I pet the people who forget about the God who promoted them. Oh, if you want to live long, never forget God. I like what Moses said to Israel. Makabos Katalabahaya. He said, remember the Lord your God who brought you out. Hey, remember the Lord your God who brought you out. Have you forgotten you was once facing shame? You were faced with an embarrassment. You were faced with humiliation. You were faced with pain, time for sickness. You were faced with a doubt confronted. And the doubt said to you that you weren't going to make it. That was the last moment. They gave you chances. They gave you time. And they broke up and gave up on you. Have you forgotten who brought you out of that sick bed? If it wasn't for the Lord who was on your side, where you would have been today? If your amen is loud, you will say amen. If you not say amen, you get the blessing. Shout out, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Let me tell you today, one of my greatest proud in these last days, one of my greatest joy that I've ever seen is men and women who these days never ever used to take Bible, but they were checking in their press, count what they have. They are on their way to entertainment center from Monday to Sunday, but the Lord has been broken. Today in our generation, you will see women that are beautiful who was used to be in club. They are in church every evening. That is a great testimony. Those days you used to see men and women, God of young generation, to talk to God. But if we could see it in our generation, thank God for God. Thank God for the great time of our generation. If your amen is still louder, you will not go back to Egypt again. Shout out, yeah. Repetition. They are living there, yes. And they are coming heat.
Yes.
Are you here?
Yes.
Don't you think they don't have comfort to their house or their home? They have comfort to their homes and they have comfort to their places. But they left their comfort zone and make their way to churches because they are building up the mentality that only him. Without him, there is no other him. Without him, we are nothing. I'm not talking to somebody here. I want to be grateful to God for many of you. You may not count it to be anything, but I count it to be something for leaving that your former attitude to be in the presence of God at this time. It's a blessing for you. Anyone that shout the amen, you get the blessing.
Amen.
Shout out,
yeah. Oh, yeah.
Hallelujah. I say hallelujah.
Yeah.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Greater concern for God that determine your welfare and your well-being in these last days. I'm not talking here. We have not come to observe preacher or a man of God or a miracle worker or a person that have the power to do things for people. But because of him and him only, we are live for and we are die for. Christ I die for. Christ I live for. I'm not talking to somebody here. I like what the entire authority said to Daniel. They said, Daniel, are we from today? The king said, we should tell you, no one should pray. Ladies and gentlemen, prayer is important than Christianity. Because if you are a Christian and you cannot communicate, you are an illegal Christian. Because every Christian must have a relationship with the owner of Christianity. You're not getting what I'm saying. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Are you hearing what I'm saying? Oh God. Oh God. Oh God. Help me here. Yeah. I want to bless somebody live here. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Are you getting my flow?
Yes, sir.
Do me a favor, Daniel. If you don't do what I'm telling you, you will lose your job. I'm willing to lose my reputation if only because of God. I'm not talking to somebody here. I look at some men who are saying they can afford a gathering for God, and I begin to smile at them. I look at some men when they're bringing the money and people are on their way to service on the Sunday morning. They ain't guilty at all. People are going to church and they are clean, that they are Christians. And when people are on their way to church, they bring their instrument outside. They buy that beer on Sunday morning and they are drinking. No consciousness of fear that today is the holy day. Let me go to worship my God. But in times of their trouble, they are running to him. To worship him, they are running from him. To serve him, they are running from him. I'm not talking here. Ladies and gentlemen, all is vanity. Vanity upon vanity. People can say, I'm big boy. Who made you big boy? There is a big God. I'm big girl. Who made you big girl? There is a big God. All your big life is because there is a big God. The day he moved from behind you, that is the end of your life. Are you hearing what I'm saying here? You agree with what I'm saying here? Concern. Concern. I'm too concerned about God that you will come to a place of telling me that, hey, please, I could bear it on my own platform and pray for you and lead you and you go home. But I prefer telling you the truth. So you go back home with the message. You could go back home with the consciousness. You could go back home with the word in your spirit that, hey, I need to build up my relationship. God, let's settle this difference. Because I don't want to be in this year without achieving anything. I don't want to go through another year again without achieving anything. You should get it at the back of your mind. Number one, he is the way. He is the way. Many young girls and boys say, I can't find my way in this life. Good quotation, wrong understanding, lack of wrong application. If you want to find your way, find him. Philip said to Nathaniel, I found him. Anyone that finds him, you found your way. When I was a Muslim, I believe I was in the wrong way, the wrong direction, the wrong people, the wrong friends, and the wrong things, and all the wrong things was at that time. But ladies and gentlemen, when I gave my life to Christ in 2018, it is no longer I that live it, but Christ that liveth in me. And it's as long as he lives inside of me. And ladies and gentlemen, and as he lives inside of me, as he doeth in me, it is Christ that lives in me. I can face tomorrow. I can face any situation. No matter the level and kinds and depths of situation, I'm able to face that thing. Why we can back off from trouble? Because Christ lives in us. Why we can back off a situation? Because Christ lives in us. I prophesy to the first 50 people under the sound of my voice. If you say the loudest amen, I baptize you with the grace of God. Shout out, yeah! Shout out, yeah!
Oh, no, no, no.
Bahaya. Hallelujah. Am I talking? Hallelujah. How will you find your way? If you can't find him, you want to find your way out, find him. Pastor, I can't understand myself. Ladies and gentlemen, the Bible says in Isaiah chapter 11, he said, the spirit of the Lord shall rest upon you, the spirit of wisdom, counsel, understanding, and knowledge. So if you want to understand yourself, endow yourself in Christ, because in Christ is where better understanding is. In this world, you will not understand anything. I'm not talking to someone here. If you want to understand how the world is going, how the world looks like, what is happening in the world, you have to find Christ. Once he's inside of you, you are rightly directed. I'm not talking here. The children of Israel, they spent 430 years in Egypt. They cry because they were being humiliated. They were being suppressed. They were being, in other words, oppressed. They pressed them down for many years. They cry the moon day and night. They wanted to find their way out, but they couldn't get out of Egypt, because by sins no one could know the way. By strength nobody could get out of that suppression. They were oppressed totally. Their father, their great-grandparents died in total humiliation. And the Bible said one day Moses came out and he saw the children of Israel being oppressed. He wanted to bring them out. He designed a strategy, but by strength no man prevailed. So Moses ran away. He got on the mountain, and then the Bible said he saw a bush that was brand new with fire, but the bush was not consumed. And the voice spoke out of the bush and said, Moses, Moses, I am the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. He said, I have seen the affliction of my people. I have not come down that I might deliver them. I'm sending you to Egypt to bring them out of Egypt. Without God, Israel could not find their way to get out. But by the divine intervention, they got out of Egypt. Can I speak to somebody here? Oh, you are coming out of your ignorance. You are coming out of your shame. You are coming out of disgrace. You are coming out of limitation. You are coming out of setback. You are coming out of delay. You are coming out of evil. You are coming out of oppression. You are coming out of depression. Everywhere you are, scatter your leisure fire. Lift up your hands, shall fire. Jump, 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 shall fire. Fire.
Fire! Fire!
Jesus' name.
Pray.
Sit up. In life, if you are in constant communication with God, prayer don't take time. Huh? If you are in constant communication with God, prayer don't take time. No. If you are in constant communication with God, prayer don't take time. Are you here? James chapter 5 verse 17.
James 5 17. Mm-hmm. Elijah was a man subject.
No way.
Elijah was a man subject Elijah. To light passion.
Okay.
As we are. Mm-hmm. And he prayed earnestly that it might not rain.
Now, if you read that part of the Bible, I started something here. I've got to know that, listen very carefully. Elijah was a man subject to love passion. And he prayed earnestly. Then I asked myself, I said, God, I want to say something here. When the Bible talks about earnestly, what does it mean? It still continued prayer. God said no. I said, but then what does it mean? Now, if you look at earnestly there, the interpretation of earnestly, watch this. It's like this. People will come here on the spot and they are here. It's a good thing, don't get me wrong. They are here for like 3 hours. Hey, Father, I want to thank you. I bless you. Fire, fire. Hey. So I say, what's the earnest prayer? Yeah, I'm gonna find for you. What's the earnest prayer? It's not a faint location. What's the earnest prayer that Elijah prayed earnestly that I want to know? It says he prayed continuously, he prayed repeatedly, or was he consistent in his prayer? And then I asked myself, and the Holy Ghost said to me, now listen, thank you for asking question. The earnest prayer is the sincerity for God. Elijah was a man sincere. A sincere man. I thought it was a man continuing prayer. Bring it back here. I believe here. Sincere. Sincere man. I said, okay now. If he says sincere man, what do you actually mean? He said, and he prayed endlessly. That what? Read your Bible. Don't close the Bible for me. He prayed endlessly.
He prayed endlessly that it might not rain.
That it might not rain.
And it rain not on the earth.
It rain not upon the earth. It was said a continued prayer. Then I traced my Bible. And the Holy Ghost took me to 1 Kings 18. It's a prayer that we're going to offer this evening. Are you ready now? 1 Kings 18. I want us to look at carefully verse 23, 24, 25 to 40. But we're going to do a bit by bit. And it's where our praying service is going to be today. 1 Kings 18. Yeah, for 23.
Verse 23 read.
Yeah, 23.
Let them therefore give us 2 bullets.
Read 22.
Then said Elijah.
Then said Elijah.
Unto the people.
Then said Elijah unto the people. Then said Elijah unto the people. Ah, even ah, only. We mean a prophet of the Lord, but bad prophet are 450 men. Let them before give us 2 bucklers, and let them choose 1 buckler for themselves, and cut in pieces, and lay it on wools, and put fire on it, and put fire, and put no fire under, and I will dress the altar. Or the other bull or buckler, and lay it on wood, and put no fire on it. Now listen very carefully. Hold that thing there. Look at verse 24, 25. We got to increase your reading and platform.
Yes,
now, if you look at something here very carefully, the Bible says, Elijah has come from the mountain. He has met Ahab. But before then, he met Obadiah. Listen, he met Obadiah. And then when he met Obadiah, Obadiah said, Elijah, what are you doing here? He said, you have been chased after. All the prophets is dead. And then Ahab car and his wife, just a bear. They are looking for you and they wanted to kill you. Listen very carefully. And then the Bible says, now he said, why, you know, they want to kill me? Now, if you read the First King 18, you read the whole thing there, but I don't want to summarize it. And then Elijah said to Obadiah, go and call Ahab. And then they call Ahab and Ahab king. And then when Ahab came, I started something about Ahab. Ahab was the king of Israel at that time. God anointed him as king over Israel. But leading over Israel, he had been manipulated by his wife and her prophets. His wife and her gods, Jezebel. Because of that, Ahab, bad prophet, has chanted the heart of the children of Israel and they turned their back on God. They turned away from God. If you read that part of the Bible, it was through the manipulation of Jezebel that make Ahab and the children of Israel to turn their back on God. It was because of the manipulation of the evil altar and the evil prophet that Jezebel had. And then according to the Bible, Elijah said to them, now you have caused the people to turn their back on God because you have built an evil platform and you are chanted on them. As I told them in the Bible, I get to know that you and I are affected by that scripture. How did we get affected? That our authors that people take your help or so and they call their name and it caused them to turn their back on you. There are many of you, the people that are there for you, their names are on evil altar. So the children of Israel turned their back on God because Jezebel and her prophet had their evil altar that was indeed working on them. So there are many of us here have people that want to be there for us, that used to be there for us, who have now turned their back on us because evil altar is working on them. So when Elijah the prophet discovered that it was an evil altar that caused the people of God to turn their back on God, he said unto them, how long are you going to turn your back on God? How long are you going to turn your back on me? How long people are going to turn their back on you? Because every man in this life is connected to a destiny helper. You can't help yourself until God sends somebody to help you. Everyone in this life will become nothing except you are connected to your helper. Will ask somebody to help you, there is nothing. When God wants to bless you, he sent a man to you. And many of you have people that are supposed to come your way and help you, make you out of where you are. But it has been very difficult. Some of them have started the process, but suddenly they have changed their mind and they have totally switched off their phone. They have put machines on their phone and caused their back to be turned on you. I discover it is not only, it is not normal, because there are places that they took that person name or their picture to an evil swamp just that you turn your back on you, so that when you call their phone, when they answer, they will get mad. There are some of you here, you are connected to family that have it, but for each time you call them to help you and when they answer your phone, they will get angry. Anytime they answer you, they will get angry. Their name is on an evil chimer that they are working on them. There are some of you, you have families that are in position. When they say they're helping you, you won't live that kind of life that you are living. But they cause them to turn your back on you and they have forgotten you. So tonight, if you are in this operation or you are in this struggle, before the 4 days come to an end, all those that turn your back on you, by the power of God, you will start getting calls, you will start getting connection, you will start getting contact, you will start receiving people. If your amen is not, I'm talking to you. Shout out, yeah. So the man said to them, sit down for me, I ain't got time. The man said to them, do me a favor. He said, now what I want you to do for me is this. He said, now tonight, do me a favor. He said, let go of my camel. Ladies and gentlemen, Elijah said, let go of my camel. In other words, you have been to where you are for too long.
You have stayed long in that situation. It's time to go over. Your level is about to change. Your condition is changing. You have been crying for the years now. After the 4 days of prayer, you will have a turnaround. The first 50 people to say a louder amen. You have a turnaround. Sit down quickly. Let's go up my cameo and then let's see what will happen. Let's go up. Tell neighbor, say, let's go up. Say, it's time to go up.
It's time to go up.
Say, you have been to where you are for long. You have been to where you are for too long.
You have been to where you are for too long.
It's time to go up.
It's time to go up.
It's time to be healed.
It's time to be healed.
It's time to be delivered.
It's time to be delivered.
It's time to be set free.
It's time to be set free.
It's time to get a visa.
It's time to get a visa.
It's time to walk out of joblessness.
To walk out of joblessness.
Say, let's go up.
Let's go up.
Sit down. That's why we are here. Amen.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. Let's go up. Now, if you are in the fast and prayer, in those days, God used to live on the mountain. So when people want to see the face of God, they go on the mountain. Now, in our days, God is no longer living in the mountain. He's living inside of you. But when the Bible says, Elijah said, let go up Mount Carmel, that tells you, anytime people want to fast, they say, I'm up. Or let go up. The Bible says, and they came down from Jerusalem, from Mount Olive, and they went up in the upper room. They went up in the upper room. He said, let's go up. Let's go up. And then the Bible say, listen and listen carefully. And maybe you not know, but I will tell you. Some of you, you don't understand the core, but I will give you the core. We take the situation. When a situation is defeating you at all time, take the battle to a neutral ground. You're not catching my floor. We are in a battleground. Am I talking to somebody here?
Yes.
Tell your neighbor, say, take the battle to a neutral ground. Say, let's go up.
Let's go up.
If you call yourself man, let's go up.
In other words,
let's meet in the spirit. Am I talking here? Am I preaching to somebody here?
Hey,
you say you're stubborn? Follow me, let's go. Am I talking here? Do you know the danger in fretting for up? To fall down? You know the danger? Oh, really? Oh, that's you? Oh, you don't know the danger in fretting for upstairs? When they push you down, you know. Oh, so you know. Oh, so you now know. Oh, so you now know when somebody push you from us there. What did the Bible say? The Bible, the scripture says, and the devil took Jesus to the high Pentecost. To the high Pentecost. And he said, look down. And then they stand up and they fall down. That's the end. Do you know what he said to him? He said, now, throw yourself down. God will give angels to take charge over you.
Amen.
Jesus said, God forbid. Satan full of strategy. Satan tell Jesus, if you call yourself, I dare you. If you, and he said, you know the danger to fight for us there? That will bring me the level down. Jesus said, Satan said to Jesus, if you know you are a true son of God, fly. You know, you are a true son of God. Throw yourself down. So even Christ know the danger to fall upstairs. He said, no, I'm a son of God. But thou shalt not put your Lord God into test. Are you here?
Yes.
Are you here?
Yes, sir.
Are you here?
Yes.
Satan is a foolish man. Amen.
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 Mm-hmm. When Satan gave you skin, we live in a generation where the young generation get tall. So it's my first time in the Bible to see Jesus. People quote it as scripture, but at all, thou shalt not pull your Lord God into test. Now, not scripture, not one at all. Mm-mm. Don't pull your God to test. If you call yourself son of God, throw yourself down. So Jesus said, no. It's not written in the Bible, throw yourself down. You throw yourself down here, you will die free. If the law, let one person fly from Australia. Are you in the service today?
Yes, sir.
Let's go up when the king. The Bible said the whole Israel, they went up the mountain. The Baal prophet, they built an altar. They built an altar. They placed the altar down. Elijah said to them, you're going to be the first to call upon your God. He said, when you call on your God, if he answered you, and fire come and consume this altar here, then your God is a God. Let me tell you something here. To serve God without a sound or a wonder, you are a Muslim. You serve God without a miracle, you serve God without evidence, you are a Muslim. Because in Islam, people do religion. In Christianity, we do warfare. For the weapon of our warfare, Anna, am I talking to somebody here? Yeah?
Yes.
Warfare, we do warfare. In Christianity, we do warfare. In Islam, the people do religion there. In Islam, people go to the mosque regular. They don't care what I, when they pray, somebody get the healing, somebody get the miracle, somebody get the restoration, not a business. As far as they're concerned, they must pay their constant head on the ground. Thank God for delivering me from my head knocking the ground. If you say amen, God will deliver plenty of people. Shout out, yeah!
Yeah!
I said, okay, fine. If you say so, let go up. When they went up, they built the altar. Mm-hmm. When they built the altar, I want you to hurry up. Give me water down there. No, I want rock. The Holy Ghost said rock. Go pick up 12 rock for us and bring it for me. 12. Bring rock. 12. They build the rock. They build book. They put bulls on it. They give goat. They place it on the rock. And the Bible says, Elijah the prophet told them, hey God, I want you to read that thing for me good. I want good reader.
Yes, sir.
Read 24.
24.
Mm-hmm.
And call yet on the name of your gods.
Do what?
Call yet on the name of your gods.
Build the altar, put rock there, put water there, and call on the name of your God. Be fast, man of God.
And I will call on the name
and
of
my God. And I will call on the name of my God.
And the God that answered by fire.
And the God that answered by fire.
Let him be God.
Let him be God. 25.
And Elijah said unto the prophet of Baal.
Elijah said unto the prophet of Baal.
Choose you one bullock
uh-huh.
for yourself.
Uh-huh.
And dress it first.
Uh-huh.
For ye are many.
Uh-huh.
And call on the name of your gods.
Call on the name of your gods.
But put on fire on us.
When you are calling your God, don't put fire there. Are you here?
Yes, sir.
Are you here?
Yes, sir.
That's what I tell people. I say, if you can pray, now you're more with all. And your fire will show it. You don't understand. What I'm saying, so, if you can pray, I told people the other time, I say, if you pray in a community and nobody murmuring, you're not praying. Amen?
Yes, sir.
Because if your prayer is hitting target, no matter who complains, fire on the mountain. Are you getting what I'm saying? Are you getting what I'm saying? There are people in neighborhood, in the same house, renting rooms together. When you put lash cream on, tune up the loudest, they won't get mad. Enjoying the show, Mara Clara, boosh. like the movie so much. Oh, I like that movie. But if you pray, he will say, why? Because of you. We can, if somebody tells you, why we can't sleep in his house, then you are on course. Are you here?
Yes, sir.
Are you here? Uh-huh. Listen, many people say, oh, why you can people can pray like that? Ah, Jesus say how to pray. You think your Bible can be convince me? You go print your own Bible, different from the Holy Scripture. Then you see different Bible. Your Bible telling you different thing, and my own telling me different thing. Somebody say, hey, why are your prayer like you're making noise? Why are your prayer like you're shouting? Why are you be shaking? Your Bible giving you wrong quotation. Check it. Are you here?
Yes, sir.
That's what I tell you. I say, stick to the word of God. Stick to it. The last days, you're going to see all kind of drama. People will print their own Bible for their own religion. Are you here?
Yes, sir.
Stick to it. Do me a favor. Pray. And the guys went to prayer. Elijah was sitting down. Let me tell you what relationship can do. That's what's going to be done here tonight. The guys went into prayer. They built the altar. Pastor, everyone, give me water. Can't give me some water bags for me. Screaming from the screen so everybody can see from outside. The guys can allegate their guests. I don't like their business. Yeah, just bring it here. Bring it. Bring five bags for me. Bring it. All this thing. Let me tell you, there's a sound. Hurry, bring it for me. Watch this. The responsibility here, this is an altar. This altar is a cause for Israel to turn your back on God. If you read that place, we read it from. Now, this altar here had caused these people to live astray for many years. God has forsaken them. They have struggled. God has abandoned them. And they can't get nothing in life for a couple of years. Now watch this. These guys there. Now know that they have been performing in the absence of the grace of God. So watch this. It is illegal to be a child of God in a community where people fly. Wait. Hear this. It is very unfair to God and illegal as a child of God, especially as a praying person. You live in a house where a witchcraft wake up, dress, fly. Listen, as soon as the God on my come here, the lost signal. As the God, listen, God can be around you perform. God can be around you change. God can be around that nonsense you do, you try it. Everyone that is living from here, you are living from here with a baptism of fire. Yeah. A fresh fire on your head. Yeah. A fresh fire on your forehead. Yeah. A fresh fire on your life. Yeah. You say amen, they will run because of you. Yeah. Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
The highest tower carry the greatest signal. The highest, you and I can have the same frequency, but we can have the highest listening audience based upon the signal. How many people hearing me will tell you they respond to me? You understand? So I have the same frequency, but the tower is higher. The frequency is 102.1. You get 102.1, I get 102.1. But my tower is higher than yours. Amen. So if I put my tower higher than you, you are going to lose signal. Don't get this thing wrong. These bar were performing. They were performing. They performed all the years. They performed as many times as they can. But when the man of God took them up the mountain where God used to live, they lost signal. The man, they went down. They chanted. They spoke their dialect. He spoke in every language you know. No way. You supposed to be in an apartment, somebody there, then they fly. You supposed to be living in a community where people are out of the... No, no. That was then. It can be now. I'm not talking to somebody here. Yes, if there are witches in your family, because of you, the 411.
Yay!
You say amen, the Lord singer.
Yay!
Shut fire!
Fire!
That's why in life, I don't want to take much time. That's why in life you value the roles of man of God in your life, because their connection to you, their hands over you, their being around you, this is the level of facility you get when they are around you. The man is different in body, but spiritually, the level of position determine your security, because the enemy platform is in the dark world. Are you here? These guys pray from morning to noon. They can't get signal. Amen. Your enemy will not catch signal. You're not catching what I'm saying. I said they will not catch signal. Are you a Buddha or a Muslim? If you are a Christian, shout it aloud. Are you here?
Yes, sir.
Are you here? The man of God gave them the longest time. Ladies and gentlemen, when you have a relationship with God, one of the things that shows is your patience. I don't get time to talk much. If you have a relationship with God, one of the things that shows is your patience. Elijah knew a relationship, so you are not shaking. While they were praying, the man of God was chewing bread, drinking cold water and kui. Relationship. I want to tell you the power of relationship. You don't have to struggle that much. Are you here? They're not doing it all day, all night. I'm doing this so that after the prayer convention, many of you should dress closer to God. I'm not talking to somebody here. They pray, they pray, they pray. It was like bringing pastor who was representing Elijah. You see them today. Scary. If like you going to do the thing, you'll be scared. But if like God going to do it, this is how you walk with him in your pocket. Are you here? That's how many people look like. I'm not talking to somebody here. Elijah didn't say, I'm a time. Elijah said, you're finished. They are set king up. They cut their hands, cut their body, and say, man, God can't change. I'm supposed to be living in a community, you wear jacket to fly. A jacket will disappear. Are you here? Elijah said, okay, excuse. Do me a favor. Read 25 for me.
25.
25.
And Elijah said unto the prophets of Baal.
Yeah, give me a rock.
Choose you.
Bring it.
One bullock.
26.
For yourself.
Be fast. Roll
26.
It.
26. And they took the bullock which was given them.
27.
27.
Yeah.
And it came to pass at noon that Elijah mocked them and said, cry aloud.
Cry aloud. You're not praying well.
For he is a God.
Increase your volume. Increase your volume. Increase your volume. Do it more. Do it more. Do it more. Cry aloud. If you read the Bible says Elijah mocked them.
Yes.
He mocked them. Cry aloud. Pray hard. If you get relationship, you only shout for passion. You don't shout for answer. You know why we shout? We shout for passion. Fire! That doesn't give you action. That doesn't give you answer, but because of the passion, it's not causing the word. Shout fire! Why we jump because of joy. We jump because it's the force that makes the prayer to be answered. Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
So Elijah said, "Cry aloud." Maybe he's not hearing you. God, 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 God.
Either he is talking.
Is your God discussing with somebody?
Or he is pursuing.
Is he in communication, chasing after somebody or something?
Or he is in a journey.
Okay. Be fast.
Or
get time.
Parivatra.
Mm-hmm.
He sleepeth.
Mm-hmm.
And must be awake.
Mm-hmm.
And they cry aloud.
And they cry aloud.
And cut themselves.
Cut themselves.
After their manner with knife and lunders.
28
is what I'm reading, sir.
Okay, go ahead now.
And they cry aloud.
29.
And it came to pass when the May Day was passed.
Go ahead faster.
And the prophets prophesied unto the time of the offering of the evening sacrifice, that there was neither voice, nor any to answer, nor any that regarded.
Okay, 29:30. Be fast now.
And Elijah said unto all the people,
unto all the people,
come near unto me.
Come near.
Hey. And all
hey,
the people.
Hey, 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 hey. Say, come near.
Come near.
Say, come closer. You can see fire.
I can see fire.
Shout that again. Say, come near. All right, read that thing for me first.
And all the people came near unto him.
All the people came near unto him.
And he replied the author of the law.
He replied the author of the law. He
that was
the of the law.
Broken down. And Elijah took 12 stones according to the number.
No, don't read that thing down. Don't read it like that. Elijah took 12 stones. Listen, wait. Let me watch something here. Elijah, if you pray that prayer anywhere, you get a response. Anyway, and I'm telling you today, when you go back home, what you should do when you are faced with a situation. Are you here?
Yes, sir.
When the battle were over, Elijah took 12 stones. Wait. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Work with me. What did he say about the stone?
He took 12 stones. And Elijah took 12 stones according to the number of the tribe of
Elijah
the son of
took
Jacob.
12 stones. Keep your eyes on the scripture. According to the numbers of the tribe of Israel, he took 12 stones. He said, this is the 12th this is the 12th tribe of Israel. Bear it over one another. Elijah didn't take buo, into 12 stones. Spiritual demonstration. He gathered them. He said, this 12 stone represent the trap of Israel. He built them. This rock. The 12th trap of Israel. Okay. And then he placed it on the altar. Are you here?
Yes, sir.
Read faster for me.
And unto the word of the Lord, King, say, Israel shall be thy name.
Elijah said, Israel shall be thy name. Where you reading from?
I just read 31.
31, right?
Yes,
okay,
sir.
Elijah took 12 stones according to the numbers of the tribe of the sons of Jacob, unto whom the word of the Lord came, saying, Israel shall be thy name. And Israel is his name. Spiritual demonstration. Are you here?
Yes, sir.
Then when he placed the stone down, see what happened. And with the stone, he built an altar with the stone. So the stones, it was what he built the altar with. Are you here?
Yes, sir.
Oh, just hold me a few minutes. 1 minute, just give me a minute. And he put wolves in order and cut the bull of the buckler in pieces and laid him on the altar. Now listen, Elijah was praying on the knee. The knee was on. And then every other thing was on top. So first, what he did, he built the knee of God. He said, this stone here represents Israel. First, Israel. Then he now collect. Let me tell you how Elijah soak the guys. There's a buckler. He called it pieces. There's a wood. He first built the tower. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. What the righteous will render in, they are safe. Before this, he said, God, this is you. This rabbi represents you. He put the star. He put the sacrifice. He put everything. Then Elijah said, now, do me a favor. He said, every one of you on the wood. And he said, do it a second time. Go bring water. Put it there. They brought water. They put it there for the first time. He said, second time. Read again. He said, third time. They put it there for the third time. He said, is everybody ready? Everybody said yes. Everybody were watching very carefully. Looking at Elijah peacefully. Pray with relationship. Is somebody catching something?
Yes.
Are you catching what I'm saying?
Yes.
Praying with relationship. Elijah! I thought it was, oh, Father God, Elijah going to get on the altar. Oh, God, you know, I'm your servant. My name is Elijah, Apostle Abraham, come on. Catch fire, catch fire, catch fire, catch fire. Fire, fire, fire. Elijah said, okay. Are you here?
Yes, sir.
Now, watch this very carefully. And it came to pass at that time of the offering, of the evening sacrifice, that Elijah the prophet came near. There's someone dressed near to God. Tell your neighbor, say, dress near to God.
Dress near to God.
Came near and said, Lord, what does that mean? You can call him once you are far for him. It's not, if you are lousy, God is not lousy. It's not everybody lousy in life. Are you here? Elijah dressed near to God. Father, I'm here. Lord, watch his prayer. Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
He came near. Lord, God of Abraham. See the thing that coming consume the altar. Isaac and Israel. And he said, Jacob. He said Israel. Do you know why he said Israel? He was in connection with the stone he put here. The 12 stone here represent Israel. This is a spiritual demonstration. God of Abraham, Isaac, others can say Jacob. But Jacob is not the real name. Because Jacob was now turned into what? Israel. Are you here? So he said the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel. I like what Elijah said. Are you here? He said, let it be known this day that thou art God in Israel, and that I am the servant, and that I have done all these things at thy word. Hear me, O Lord, hear me. Hear me. That the people may know that thou art the Lord God, and that thou hast torn their heart back again. This is a prayer we're going to pray tonight. Then the fire of the Lord fell. The fire of the Lord fell not through prayer. It fell through syllables. Words. Are you catching what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Say Elijah prayer. Lord God of Abraham. First of all, he dressed near. Honor authority, Lord God of Abraham, Isaac, Israel. Let this be known today that Israel may know that there is a God. Are you here?
Yes.
That there is a God in Israel. Let the fire be, let the altar be consumed by fire that Israel may know that you are God. Elijah was standing up. The Bible didn't say he was praying. He was standing up. Fire fell. When the fire fell, it bruised the altar. The altar was consumed. And the people saw it. Kabalosh katalabahaya. And the people saw it. The altar caught fire. And the people saw it. Elijah has pray. I told people, I said, what is killing many people is religion. It is that religion that causing problems. When their problem choke them, then they're looking for place to run. But he that answered by fire, let him be God. The fire from heaven fell upon the altar and consumed the altar. When the people saw it, the Bible said they all turned back to God. Ladies and gentlemen, after the praying summit, yeah,
there's going to be a fire in the praise section tonight that is going to fall on your family altar. After the altar catch fire, all those that turn their back on you, they will begin to ask for your numbers. Am I speaking here? Whether you are outside or inside, by the reason of the prayer tonight, fire is going to fall down in your village, in your hometown. If your amen is the loudest, something is about to happen here. Whether you are upstairs or downstairs, I don't like that your amen at all. You say amen, God will bless you.
Are you here? My Father, my Maker, as I pray, all those that turn their back on me, all those that the enemy turned away from me, ladies and gentlemen, pray the prayer with bitterness. I'm not talking to somebody here. Elijah burned the altar and the helper run back to the people, and the people ran back to God. I'm not speaking here. Lift up your hand, clap it. Say, my Father. Outside, inside, my father. As I begin to pray. Every altar. Turning the back of my helper.
Against me.
Allah.
Let fire fall.
And consume this altar.
Whatever they're using,
to turn your back on me.
To turn your back on me.
Whatever they are using on you.
What they use on you.
That causing you to turn your back on me.
That causing you to turn your back on me.
As I open my mouth and pray.
Open my mouth and pray.
Let me give you another say before you pray. When I'm saying whatever they are using, I'm telling you about swamps. Evil people. People who use things against your family members, against your relationship, against your partners. Make them to turn back on you. Amen. 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 Say, my father, my maker. Say, whatever they are using. Whatever they are using against me. Whatever they are using
against my helper.
Whatever they are using on you to turn your back on me. As I pray tonight, by fire batona, that thing catch fire. Open your mouth and cry. On the country, on the poor people, and they will start suffering. You don't know what is there that can cause that thing to happen. Let's pray this time around, whatever that thing is. Because when thing get hard for you, you will not pay children's school fee. When thing get hard for you, you will not pay all rent. I'm not talking to somebody here.
Say, my father, my maker.
My father, my maker.
Whatever that cause our leaders.
Whatever that cause our leaders.
That always turn our back on us. As I pray with fire and thunder. That thing catch fire. Makabara taya baba baya. Poroto ye berararararara. Shakata ya baba barata. Baraka toyata.
Get up,
be a man of fire. In Jesus' name.
There are many of us here today. Our families. Some of our families are into a tortoise shell. All we experience is slow life. Things move, but it moves slowly. Many of us here, our families are into various things. We are going to ask God to bring you out. You might be innocent. You might not know, but you are suffering from it. So pray as an innocent person. God, whatever my family is into that I don't know that I am facing, bring me out tonight by fire. If you look at me like that, you really you say, my father, my maker. As I begin to pray, whatever my family is into, as for me, I am innocent. I don't know nothing about it. As I begin to pray, don't let this year pass by me. Bring me out. Bring me out. Bring me out. Open your mouth.
Bring me out.
Bring me Fire prayer. Bring me out. Bring me and my family out. Bring my children out. Bring my children out. Bring my children out. Bring me out. Bring them out. Bring them out. My Father, my God. Bring them out. In Jesus' name, everybody, whatever you are, maybe there is a spiritual projection. Maybe that I fooled a gift to you in your dream. Maybe the enemy fired the arrow by food or by sex in the dreams. There are many of us, we ate food in the dreams, and there are things we did in the dreams that is causing that arrow to be burning our body. And there are some situation in your body that is bending that the enemy put inside of you to kill you. There are some things inside you the enemy using to monitor you. You are going to pray tonight. Whatever old thought that is in my stomach, that is a cause I can't get a child, that is a cause I can't get a relationship, that is a cause I can't get a job, that is a cause I can't serve God, that is a cause I can't go far, that altar planted inside of me, that is a cause of this sickness, that is a cause of the pain, as I lay my hands on my stomach, that altar built in my stomach, what I built by food, by intercourse in the dream, by water in my dream, or I ate it by physical food, or I came by the means of pressing, that is embarrassing my life, as I bring it to pray, as I begin to pray, every altar in me, by fire, by force, by lengthy, by toner, come out now. Anything the enemy planted in me, come out now. Lay your hands on your stomach, wherever you are. Say, my Father, my Maker. I can hear you, my Father, my Maker. As I begin to pray,
every altar
in my stomach, causing this affliction. As I pray now, come on.
Come on!
Come on!
Come on!
Usher, it's coming out, it's coming out. They are coming out, they are coming out. Everything the enemy put inside of you, they are coming out. Every sickness that's in you, Usher, look at what happened in the Usher. Makapos, Kataya Bahaya, Makatara Bahaya. Every nightmare, every night woman behind your life, every person in your stomach, they are coming out. By vomit, by urine, by defecation, they are coming out. 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 Come on. Usher, 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 something happening here. Usher, look at that, look at that. Usher, look at outside. Protocol all over. Us, that's outside. Power, power, power. They are coming out, they are coming out. That last one, the blend in your stomach. That being the center of your way. That arrow, the fire in your direction. It's coming out, 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 it's coming out. Everywhere you are, open your mouth and pray. Whether you are outside, you are irregular, everything that pressing you, everything that gives to you, whatever the enemy does to you, project inside of you. It's coming out, 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 come 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 out, every fibros. People are getting delivered. It's coming out. All over. People are getting free. Everything in your throat. Everything in your system. Everything in your leg. Everything in your stomach. Be a fibrous. be it barrenness, every affliction, they are coming out, coming out, coming out, coming out, coming out, coming out, come out, 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 come out! Come out! Come out! Come out! Come out! Come out! Out, 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 every sickness out, every power out, every pain out, barrenness out, disease out, fibros out, kidney problem out, liver problem out, affliction out, infirmity out, come out. In Jesus' name!
That's it. From here, we all get, if we participated, that's it. We all have received a general miracle. General miracles. If your amen is loud, everything inside you is Abba fire.
You say amen, they are Abba fire. Amen. In the name
of Jesus.
Worship. Whatever you are there worshiping, tell him thank you. He that answered prayer, tell him thank you. Everybody worshiping. Look at the master's deliverance. Look at the master's deliverance.